أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Hello dear ladies and gentlemen In today lecture I am going to discuss with you about proteins So what is protein? Protein are very large molecule macrobiopolymers made from monomer called amino acid There are 20 strain amino acid each containing a carboxyl group An amino group and a side chain known as in R group. The R group is what makes each amino acid different and the properties of the side chain greatly influence the overall three-dimensional conformation of a protein. When amino acid combine, they form a special bond called a peptide bond through dehydration synthesis and become a fully peptide or protein. In order to determine whether two proteins are related or in other words to decide whether they are homologous are not scientists use sequence comparison method like sequence alignment and structure alignment and are powerful tool that help scientists identify homologies between related molecules. The relevance of finding homologies among protein goes beyond forming an evolutionary pattern of protein families by finding how similar two protein sequences are we acquire knowledge about their structure and therefore their function. Most protein consist of linear polymer built from series of up to 20 different L amino acid. All proteogenic amino acid possess common structural pattern, including a carbon to which an amino group, a carboxyl group, and a variable side chain are bonded. Only proline differ from this basic structure as it contains an unusual ring to the end in amino group. Which forces the carbon NH amide moiety into a fixed conformation. The side chain of the standard amino acid detailed in the list of standard amino acid have a great variety of chemical structure and properties. It is the combined effect of all of the amino acid chain in a protein that ultimately determine its three-dimensional structure and its chemical reactivity. The amino acid in a polypeptide chain are linked by peptide bonds. Once linked in the protein chain, an individual amino acid is called residue, and the linked series of a carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen atom are known as the main chain or protein backbone. The peptide bond has two resonance forms that contribute some double bond character and inhibit rotation and its axis, so that the alpha carbon are roughly coplanar. The other two dihedral angle in the peptide bond determine the local shape assumed by the protein backbone. The end of the protein with a pre-carboxyl group is known as the C-terminus or carboxy terminus, whereas the N-terminus or amino terminus, the word protein polypeptide and peptide are a little ambiguous and can overlap in meaning. Protein is generally used to refer to the complete biological molecule in a stable conformation, whereas peptide is generally reserved for a short amino acid oligomers, often lacking a stable three-dimensional structure. However, the boundary between the two is not well defined and usually lies near 20 to 30 residues. Polypeptide can refer to any single linear chain of amino acid, usually regardless of length, but often implies an absence of a defined conformation. If you have any question, please ask in the comments. I will answer regularly of your question.